Women shut out at the club. 10 News investigates tonight at 11.
You just, you know, you're really kind and you're really beautiful. That was a mistake.
Are you trying to scare me, Connor?
No. No, I'm sorry. You're the last person on this earth that I want to hurt.
Seeing Christina only made me miss her more. I feel this empty space inside of me that used to be filled with love, and I can't keep feeling like that, Jason. I want to have another baby.
Sam, I know. I know that you're hurting. And having another baby seems like a way to make it stop, but you need time to heal your body emotionally.
I think becoming a mother will be all the healing I need to feel that little person growing inside me again. It would just make the world seem right, Jason.
It's too soon to be talking like this.
You and I were going to raise my child together. You lost what I lost. Don't you want another chance?
Look, there's got to be a way to stop Rick from going after Sonny.
Look, Carly, I'll do whatever I can do, but the man is the district attorney. If he has evidence incriminating Sonny, I can't order him not to use it.
Yeah. Well, can't you pressure him? Look, I mean, there's got to be some legal way to stop. Wait, Sonny doesn't even know Rick's going
after him. Carly, where are you going?
I'm going to warn Sonny.
Carly, I do not want you involved in this.
I already am.
Sonny, you're under arrest.
This is about the restraining order,
no,
Rick.
Sonny, that's
I
not
my
why
lawyer
we're
lifted.
You're under arrest for tax fraud, extortion, and money laundering. You're going to prison for the rest of your life. It's over. Coven Reedham's right.
Stop. Please stop.
What's the problem?
Don't do this here. Not here. Not in front of me. Not in front of Christina.
Found out Mary had been killed, all I wanted to do was lash out against the world, you know? And if I died, I really didn't care. But you showed me that I was wrong, that I could still have a future.
Well, underneath all of that rage, Connor, I could see that you were a good man.
Well, I don't know how. I mean, I was acting like a maniac. But that's over. I'm ready to move on.
I'm happy for you, Connor. I knew it would happen.
Well, see, there's a reason for that. I think I can start a new life because of you.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Must be a little dusty in here.
That's part of the ambiance. Keep a little dust in the air and the customers stay thirsty.
Speaking of which, is it hot in here? Or is it just us?
I'd like to apologize.
For barging in without knocking? Please don't let it happen again.
For walking out when I should have been working. Reopening the Haunted Star is such a big job, and really, I had no right to storm out like that.
Apology accepted.
All right. There, see? If we keep working together, all our dreams will come true.
All my dreams are very specific, Luke. You better rest up.
Getting pregnant made me a better person. I just don't want to lose that.
Sam, you were always a good person. Getting pregnant didn't change you as much as you think.
Trust me, Jason, all I ever thought about was myself.
That's not true. I've seen you with your brother.
But it's not the same thing.
Why not?
Because Danny is sweet and trusting. He's like a little kid. I always had to think for the both of us.
You're willing to go to jail to protect him.
I'm all he has. I love him a lot.
Right. That love was a part of you before you were pregnant. It's a part of you right now, and it's always going to be there whether you have another baby or not.
You miss the baby as much as I do. Why should we go on like this? Just aching for her. Jason, we could have another baby.
Sam, you're not ready. Neither am I.
Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law.
This is exactly what I meant. No child should see their father dragged away in handcuffs.
Yeah? Well, blame your husband, not me.
I'm just doing what I'm paid to do.
You know what? I was willing to negotiate some kind of compromise because I thought it was best for Christina, but not now. I'm going for custody. Christina's gonna live with me. You're the one who's gonna have supervised visits.
You can't even stop making threats when you're in handcuffs.
Well, you know what? This is temporary. What happens in court is permanent.
Yeah, well, you keep dreaming, Sonny.
Well,
you think you're gonna be eligible for custody now? You're gonna be a convicted felon facing years in prison. Not exactly a poster child
for
Father of the Year. Yeah. Let's get him in the elevator.
All right, whatever.
Let's go.
Hey, let him go.
Carly, this is a police matter. Interference at this point is going to constitute arrest.
I'm not letting you take him, okay? You know, I expect this from you, Rick, because you have no conscience. You don't know the difference between right and wrong. But Alexis, how could you do this? Sonny gave Christina his deceased baby's stem cells. And your husband, isn't that what he is now? And these trumped-up charges, they could have waited another
okay,
day.
I've heard enough. You need to step aside.
Don't touch my wife. I'm not letting you take him. This is ridiculous, Sonny.
Go.
You want me to call
Carly,
Jason?
Carly,
I'll call
Jason. I will take care of it.
Rick, you know what? You're going to pay for this. One day it's going to come and it's gonna grab you right
Carly,
in the...
Let this one go.
I'm gonna pay, Rick.
Pick your battles. Pick battles you can win.
Alexis, look at me. What are you, in a daze or something? Hey! Sonny saves Christina's life, and this is how you show your gratitude?
And just being around you made me feel like I'd be okay.
And you will. Connor, once you're out of Port Charles and your problems with the military have been solved,
It's already happened. No, if you just give me a chance, I really think I can make you happy.
You don't even know me, Connor.
I know, but you know, we've already been through so much together, and I think that when two people go through a lot, they get to know each other a little faster.
You've lost the love of your life, and you want to replace her. But I'm not available. I'm in love with Nicholas.
That could change.
It won't. Connor, do what we originally planned. Leave the country tonight, and you can start a new life.
So you could come with me?
No, I can't. My life is here with Nicholas. Connor, I'll think of you, and I'll pray that you find love again.
All right. I'll go to Canada, and I'll take what I know with me.
It's the right decision.
Nicholas don't deserve you. Someday you'll know that.
Sky, I put up the money to save this place. You work for me. Is there some part of that you don't understand?
No.
Because one more act of insubordination, one more little tantrum from you, and you're out of here for good.
Heather, my partner and I have been over the game plan. We know exactly how this is going to play out.
Luke, whatever you say. Having you back in my life gives me an incredible sense of peace. Oh, on second thought, I don't think you should be back there. Behind the bar is no place for a drunk.
Except, of course, for the owner of the joint who's never over an arm's reach from the booze. Would you mind oiling the roulette wheel? I hear something squeaking.
Sure, Luke. Anything for you.
Oh, Skye, try not to dress so dowdy tonight. I mean, we want the atmosphere to be festive, not frumpy.
Skye's look is always classic. She knows her priorities. The important thing here is that we all get what we want.
Well, in that case, Skye, just stay out of the way. Luke and I will greet the guests as they arrive.
The next person you will be greeting is my attorney.
Oh, sweetheart, it's so good to see you.
Don't sweetheart me, you tarantula. You're finished spending my money.
The baby is still with me. She always will be. She can't be replaced.
I'm not saying we should forget her.
I know. But you want a reason to keep going, and having a baby just to make yourself feel better. It's not.
It's not what? Why not, Jason? Why not make a child for both of us to love?
Sam, I don't understand. I know that you're in pain, and I know that you're afraid you're always gonna be, but you'll heal. With time, it's gonna get easier, but having a baby is not the answer.
Hello, Sam. How are you feeling?
Great. Dr. Meadows, how soon could I have another baby?
Do you believe those two? After everything that Sonny did for Christina, they have him arrested in the hospital while he is visiting his own child.
Rick has a job to do. He can't make exceptions.
Whoa, are you going to defend Rick Lansing now?
Okay, Carly, no. I just want you to calm down.
Okay, then help me. Please, because we do not have much time. Rick claims that he has evidence against Sonny. I need to find it, and I need to destroy it.
You're kidding me, right?
No, I'm not kidding you. Sonny and I may be on the outs, but he is still the father of my children, and helping him means I help them.
Sonny has a lawyer. Why don't you just call him or her and just be done with it?
Oh, because in my opinion, lawyers are really overrated.
So you're gonna break into a DA's office and you're gonna destroy police evidence?
No.
Well, that's comforting.
Good, because I'd be wasting my time. The evidence isn't there.
Okay, what makes you so sure of that?
Listen, if Rick thinks the evidence is as important as he claims for it to be, then he's not going to take the chance of having too many people have access to it. He's got it stashed away somewhere that he figures no one's gonna be able to touch it. What?
I've worked with some very analytical minds, and very few of them are as fast as yours.
I told you we're in a hurry. You gonna help me or not?
Emily, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have left the way I did.
No, it's okay.
No, it's not. I mean, it's okay for us to disagree, but I can't go running off angry every time we do.
Wait, Nicholas, you're right. I've been sending Connor mixed signals by trying to support him.
What do you mean? What happened?
He came on to me again, and I put a stop to it immediately, but he asked me to leave the country.
Where is he right now?
He finally agreed to take a plane out of here tonight, but I have a terrible feeling that he's not going to go through with it.
You have no idea how glad I am to see you.
You can see me just fine, right from there.
The game is over. My father knows everything. I don't know what you've been told, but I wasn't responsible for having you committed.
You did everything but drive the van.
It was all Tracy. She wanted control of your money.
You know what? I told my father what I did. Now it's your turn.
You warned me about her yourself. You said that she was a greedy little schemer, incapable of being honest. You don't think she's telling the truth about this?
I had my doubts. But then I had a little chat with Dr. Lightfoot, the psychiatrist you paid off.
I did nothing of the kind.
You're telling me he's lying too?
I certainly am. Tracy must have bribed him.
The family was right all along, Heather. You're a money-grubbing fortune hunter. You'll never get a dime on my money. This marriage is over as soon as the papers are signed.
Edward, you're being manipulated, but not by me.
I know. I know I was manipulated. But it won't happen again.
Luke, don't worry. Our business venture will not be affected by this temporary misunderstanding between my husband and myself.
Edward, if I were you, I'd rethink that divorce thing.
Why, Luke? So you can reopen the club with the money Heather stole from me?
No, sir. Because if you divorce that woman, you're going to be dead before the ink is dry.
It's not uncommon for women who've lost a child to want to conceive again quickly. But in your case, it won't be possible.
Why not?
When the abruptio placenta occurred, it caused extensive bleeding in your uterus. At one point, your doctor considered a hysterectomy.
Without my permission? Can he do that?
Well, if your life is at stake, he would have no other choice. But fortunately, it didn't come to that.
Can I still have children?
Absolutely. Absolutely. But your body needs time to recover. And there's no telling how long that'll take.
What would happen if there were an accident, or...
At best, the pregnancy would be difficult to sustain. At worst, it could be fatal. You are more fragile than you realize, Sam. And if you push yourself too soon, you could put your own life at risk.
When I went out, I bought you a tape, The Birds in the Backyard. And we're gonna watch it when you get home, okay? I have lots of things, but I have lots of presents for you waiting at home. Okay?
Alexis.
Yeah.
Hey, I know it's Christina's birthday, so I brought her a gift.
It's really nice of you. We'll make sure that she gets it.
Is Christina all right?
She's getting stronger every day. I think that I'm going to be able to bring her home for the holidays.
Good. Then maybe I can come over and spend some time with her.
I really like you. And I hope that you don't take this personally. I'm just reluctant to let her form any attachments to Sonny's family at this point.
Christina is Sonny's child. If he gets to spend time with her, so do I.
Sonny's just been arrested for racketeering. The time that he'll be spending is in prison.
What charges are you going to bring against Mr. Corinthos?
No comment.
Any regrets about putting your own brother behind bars?
All right. No more questions until the suspect has been booked. That's it.
Hey, you sure about this?
Yes, I'm positive. Listen, give me a little minute alone with him. I'd like to talk to him for a second. Okay?
Okay.
He's all yours.
Take these clips off now. Take them.
Right in here.
Easy.
Right in here.
Mr. Durant, were you personally involved in arresting Sonny Corinthos?
No, I wasn't. I wasn't involved at all.
Do you mind District Attorney Lansing getting all the credit, or?
Well, he did the work. If Mr. Corinthos is convicted, DA Lansing deserves the credit.
Okay.
Kind of hurt me with the handcuff there.
Yeah, we can send us a medical bill. Please sit down.
I don't feel like sitting down.
Okay, right? Being uncooperative at this point is not going to help you.
I don't want to hear your phony concern. Tell me what you think you have on me, Rick.
Come on, Stephen, you've consulted on cases for Rick before. You gotta have some idea where he might have that evidence hidden.
If I did, I wouldn't tell you.
Why? Because you care about me, you don't want me to get hurt.
That's part of it.
Okay, well, care about me less, Stephen, okay? Because I gotta find that evidence, I gotta get rid of it before Rick uses it against Sonny.
Carly. It's called obstruction of justice. Do you have any idea what the penalties for that are?
Listen, Sonny just lost his baby daughter. He and I are separated, and now his brother wants to put him away in prison for life. I'm not going to let
Sonny
that happen,
Stephen.
Sonny
is a career criminal. You shouldn't be surprised, nor is it your fault that he's facing a prison term.
Look, I am so beyond assigning any blame for any of this. But I stand up for the people that I care about, and I care about Sonny, and I always will.
I don't know your husband. But I think that he'd want you to stay out of this. And so that's what I'm telling you too, Carly. Stay out of it.
So I'm on my own. You know, you said you wanted to be my friend. This was a chance, and you just blew it.
Hello?
Sonny's been arrested.
I know, I'm at the police station right now.
I'm on my way.
Carly,
there's nothing you can do about it.
Yeah, well, I have to try. Look, I'm about to say something that I never thought I would have to say in my life.
And what's that?
I need your help, Dad. Please.
Do you remember that little jumper gown that I bought? The one with the pink polka dots? Well, I laid it out on the bed last week and then I put it over my shoulder and I held it tight, pretending my baby was in it, and I danced around the room. If anyone would have seen me, they would have thought I was crazy for sure.
Not me.
Jason, do you believe in heaven? That somewhere there's a God looking down on us?
Yes, I do.
What about proof?
When I stand by the ocean looking out to the horizon, I can't explain it. I just feel like I'm part of something, you know, bigger than myself. And that's all the proof I need.
For me, it's the stars. Just looking up in the sky and feeling small and important. Same time, scared, yet happy to be a part of it. Do you think there are stars in heaven?
I think there's everything you want for the baby. Love, no security, happiness. Stars.
You can blame me if you like. I accept that. But if Sonny's been arrested, it's Sonny's fault. Your son is a gangster, Mike, and it was only a matter of time before the authorities would be able to prove that.
So now you can feel justified in all you did to keep Sonny from knowing that Christina was his daughter.
I'm sure that you can understand that I'm just trying to keep her safe.
And you assumed that Sonny would be a threat?
I have no doubt that Sonny would move heaven and earth to protect Christina and his boys. I believe he'd even sacrifice his own life for them if necessary. He would do anything for his children, anything. Except change the way he lives. He lives a life of crime, and that has consequences, whether Sonny likes it or not.
Thank you.
I have conclusive proof of your illegal activities. I'll submit the file at your arraignment. Your attorney can view it then. I don't want to do this now, Sonny.
Mrs. Corinthos, are you here to post bail for your husband?
Is your husband innocent, Mrs. Corinthos?
Yes.
Do you know who will be representing him at his trial?
There isn't going to be a trial.
Are you sure?
Back off!
That's
go outside.
Have you had any luck? Have you spoken to Rick about suppressing the evidence?
No, they've been in there since I got here.
You are going to pressure him, though, right?
Hey, Rick's been waiting for this for a long time. He's not going to walk away just because I tell him to back off.
Listen, it is a frame-up, as usual. Rick will fold if you convince him that he's going
to
lose.
All right, look, Carly, I'll do whatever I can to scare him, okay?
Thanks.
But, Carly, you got to prepare yourself. If he doesn't walk away from this thing, Sonny's going to be arraigned in the next 24 hours.
Is Rick going to have to present the evidence then?
Yeah. Otherwise, there's no case.
John, does Lansing know the evidence came from you?
No. And he never will.
Wow, I never thought I'd see you hand over a high-profile win to another prosecutor.
Krynthos is out of my daughter's life forever. Carly will trust me more than ever. I'd say it's the best trade-off of my life.
You framed Sonny before Rick, and it didn't work. What makes this so different?
I am not framing him, Carly. The evidence that I have is undeniable proof of Sonny's criminal activity.
Lansing,
you better be right about this, because if this case goes bad, it could cost you your job.
The case is solid, and Sonny's going away for the rest of his life.
Uh-huh. You thought that before, and you were wrong.
Sure? Yeah. Maybe he couldn't find you.
No, Emily, he knew exactly where we were supposed to meet. You were right. He's not leaving tonight.
Nicholas, we have to find him before he tells the police that you killed Helena.
You leave Connor to me, all right? All right, I love you. I love you.
I love you too, but... Nicholas, what are you going to do?
No, I love you, okay? Bye.
Laura was living in our attic?
You're absolutely sure about that.
Dylan found her. He said she was still wearing the wristband from the hospital. He rushed right over here, but by the time we got to the attic, Heather had already moved her.
Why? Why would Heather keep Laura hidden from the world?
Same reason she pinned Ross Duncan's murder on me. So she could have Luke all to herself.
Oh, I'm sorry. No offense.
None taken? My guess is that she planned to marry you, bump you off, and show up at my doorstep a rich widow.
See, Lila's death was just a happy accident for Heather, Edward. By marrying you, she could finance her whole demented plan to have Luke for herself.
God, this whole thing seems so surreal.
Maybe you just don't want to admit how thoroughly you were bamboozled, Daddy.
Now that you've told Heather you plan to divorce her, she's going to try to kill you.
That's ridiculous. She has to know she can't get away with that.
Edward, she's already gotten away with a whole hell of a lot. The way to stop her, I think, is to go ahead and let her take a shot at you.
Time. Enjoy your freedom. You next.
What has he told you?
Look, the way he's acting, he may have his hands on Myra's file.
Rick, I almost forgot to congratulate you. I came to town to nail Krynthos, and you did the job.
Well, thank you, John. Maybe your coming to town was just the incentive I needed.
That's very kind of you. You mind sharing with me how you made your case?
Yeah, I got lucky.
I guess we all did.
Hey, come on, really, I really need to get into Mr. Lansing's room.
Why is that?
I left some things in there.
Like what?
Panties, bras, sorted accessories.
You're gonna have to wait till Mr. Lansing gets home.
All right, that's fine with me, really, it's okay, but what if Mr. Lansing comes home with his new wife? She's gonna find my stuff, the marriage is gonna be over before it begins.
Make it fast.
Thank you.
In her mind.
Am I crazy?
The one woman who hates her is the only one who can save her.
Swing to me!
On One Life to Live.
You harm Christian in any way and I'm gonna kill you.
You're gonna die.
It's the end of the Santis. And on General Hospital, out of a tragedy, a love story begins.
You really care about her, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
All My Children, One Life to Live, and General Hospital. It's a November to Remember on ABC Daytime.
What are you doing here?
Changed my mind about leaving.
They'll arrest you as a deserter, Connor.
It'll be worth it. I'm gonna tell the police Nicholas Dewey's grandmother off a cliff.
Please, Connor, I'm begging you not to do that.
Doesn't matter what he does. I've already confessed.
Do you know what it's doing outside right now? It's snowing. White snow, and it's gonna cover the whole city, and you know what we're gonna do when you feel better? We're gonna make a giant snowman. Would you like that? You're sleeping. You could shut your eyes wide, dog, if you want. I know you don't want to be spending your birthday in the hospital, sweetheart. But you're gonna have so many more birthdays, so many more. You're gonna have a whole lifetime full of them. And that'll be our gift this year. For you to be healthy and safe.
You dodged a bullet tonight, huh, Morgan? Whatever Lansing's got on Sonny must not mention you by name.
You know exactly what Lansing has on Sonny because you gave it to him.
Oh. Well, how'd you come up with that?
Rick has been so focused on Christina and Alexis, he hasn't had the time or the interest to build a case against Sonny. This was your work. Now you're using Lansing as a cover? You're the one who got Sonny arrested.
This is not what I wanted.
Yeah, it is.
Well, you better enjoy it while it lasts, because it's not going to last very long.
I have resented you from the minute that I learned that you existed.
Uh-huh.
Okay, and I wanted to put you away for racketeering. It's the main reason that I took this job. But I wanted to put away the hardened criminal. I didn't want to put away the father who was grieving for his child.
I don't want your sympathy.
All right, you're not going to get any. Only regrets.
Is there a priest, maybe, or a therapist you can talk to about this?
Yeah, I want you to know that I wish things were different. That we had grown up together, that we were brothers in spirit as well as in blood.
You want to be my brother, Rick? Huh? You want to be my brother? Tell me and give me that file. Because I know it's not you, Rick. You know, you're just a front man. Somebody else set me up. I'm gonna find out who.
That you don't mean a word of it.
I'm the one who tried talking him out of it.
You let him do your dirty work.
It doesn't matter where I got it. The evidence against you is legit.
Carney, open the door! Carney, are you all right?
How could a day that begins like this...
It's 5 a.m. I really should go.
...end like this?
I'm giving notice. Now step aside before I push you to the ground.
An all-new Boston Legal this Sunday, 10, 9 Central, only on ABC.